about maybe half an inch on each side. Challenge yourself over again. You'll feel yourself at a wee sticking point, and just try and push through that and start working on it every week, or every time you're going to do a shoulder workout or another body workout. Just get the shoulders warm up well.
Okay, should be good. Good stuff.
Okay, folks, so the next one up is just to put the shoulders correctly. You can do this on a stool at home, or you can do it on the same kitchen table. I'm just going to repeat the demonstration here. It's going to place both hands, fully stretched arms, base of the hands is still on the box. He's going to press his hips backwards towards the back wall and drive his chest and head down into the floor, keeping his arms nice and straight. He should feel the strain on the front of the shoulders right through to the back of the shoulder. As he goes down, he breathes out. And he takes a couple of deep breaths in and out. As he raises up out of it slightly, deep breath in, breathe out, and push the chest back down again. He's going to make a wee bit more room, and he's going to go slightly deeper, put a wee bit more pressure in the shoulder joint. Then, after about 10 seconds of holding that position, he's going to come slightly up and let the pressure off, rotate his right thumb up to the ceiling, and he's going to try and lift his hand off the box without raising his upper body. So he's going to stretch, and he should feel that pressure, back down, and one more, raise up, back down, change hands, and try and raise that hand, hold it steady for 3 or 4 seconds, back down, and one more, and after that he's going to go straight back down into what he did at the start, and just repeat the same thing over again, and that should keep the shoulders nice and loose. Okay folks, so next up we're going to do some hip mobility, and it'll work on your lower back as well. So it's called Scorpion Kick, and I'm going to get Pete to demonstrate here. So Pete just face down, arms out wide in a T position, so the body's like shaped T, and he's going to bring, keeping his shoulders, try and press the shoulders into the floor, don't rotate too much the upper body. He's going to work on his lower back and his hips. He's going to rotate one foot over as high as he can, up towards his hands, and get his heel to touch the floor. So away we go, breathe out, make some room, touch, and back over, rotate to the other side, and touch again, good stuff, and keep breathing every exercise, deep breath in. How's that feel?
Like shit.
All good? Okay folks, so next up is another hip mobility exercise, and it's called the groiner. So I'm going to just get Pete to get into a pressing position, hands directly below the shoulders, and he's going to step forward. First go with the left foot so you can see it properly. Left foot comes up to the outside of the heel, just relax the back knee down to the floor. Now in this position, just bring your foot back a wee bit. Yeah, knee is directly above your ankle here, so there's not too much of a stretch. He's going to press his knee away slightly from the body, so he's opening up that groin, and then he's going to drop his inside elbow down the inside of his ankle and breathe out, exhale the whole way down. And if it's a wee bit uncomfortable, you can't reach the floor, don't worry. He's going to come back up again, deep breath in at the top. Make some room, breathe out, get down that wee bit further. And just hold it down there for maybe 8 to 10 seconds. And repeat the same on the opposite side. You will be a wee bit uncomfortable, but that's the whole point. Just relax and step back. And just repeat on the same on both sides, maybe another 3 to 4 times. And you should be all good to go for your squats.
Squats!
Okay folks, so next one up is ankle mobility. I'm going to show you one exercise here. Pete's going to show you it, and I'll just talk him through it. He's going to first off just put his right foot on the edge of the box, so his left foot's out past, he's not restricted to his depth. He's going to grab a kettlebell, okay, and he's going to just get forward with that knee into like a lunge position, so it's nearly like in the single leg squat as such, and the back leg is just taking the pressure of his weight as well. So he's just going to press down, knees coming forward, he's getting this nice dorsiflexion here, but he's actually activating all these muscles, keeping his heel on the platform, and you can feel that stretch coming up the back of the Achilles. And he's hanging out there for 10 seconds, and then release, and then keep pressing down and forward, and getting a wee bit deeper every time, and you should get more ankle mobility there. Take all that tightness out, and you should be able to sit more upright in your squats. He's a strength athlete now.
Strength, not a strength athlete anymore.
No, that was bloody perfect. So let's sign this thing off like we normally do with a vlog. Me holding the camera, saying to Mark, thank you very much for the information on mobility. And could you finish by saying something motivational?
Something motivational.
That'll do nicely. Peace. because I'm a PT.